So I decided to change my hotel. In this video, I'm gonna let you guys know what I changed my hotel to for one of my future trips that I have coming up. And I think it's more valuable in the long run, but yeah, for more videos like this one, hit that subscribe button. But for now, let's go ahead and get into the video. Boom! What's up guys, it's Jay and welcome to Flashpoint, where we're all about credit, credit cards, and other finance tips. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Also, give this video a thumbs up, it really helps me out, and comment down below with your thoughts on this video. I really appreciate it. So, like I said earlier in the video, that I decided to go ahead and change one of my bookings for a hotel. I originally made a video on how I was gonna redeem my Marriott Bonvoy points, but I decided to switch to Hyatt. And if you're a points and miles person and you know about why I would switch to Hyatt, then you obviously know that if you transfer Chase Ultimate Rewards points to Hyatt, you can get a lot of value out of those points, and Hyatt is usually one of the best ways to redeem Chase points. So my original booking was for the Gwen Hotel, and it was slightly up on the Magnificent Mile in Chicago, and that was going for 35,000 points a night, and the total was gonna be 70,000 points. I was only gonna be there for 3 days and two nights. So after some thought, I decided to go ahead and see what Hyatt was offering out there, and I know that they just added a few hotels to their collection of hotels, like the Thompson Hotels. And one thing I didn't know was that they have one of the hotels that I actually had dinner at a while back when I was visiting some of my family out there. And that restaurant is Cindy's Rooftop, and it's a part of the Chicago Athletic Association Hotel. So I went ahead and booked my stay there. It's a lot closer to Soldier Field because I am going to a Bears game. So that's pretty awesome that it's a lot closer to the stadium, because if you've ever been there, it's the traffic, even if you're taking an Uber or anything like that, it can be pretty hectic down the Magnificent Mile, especially before a Bears game. It can almost take you, like, even as close as I'll be, it might even take an hour. So it's almost better for me to walk or take like a pedicab or something like that. So anyways, I'm going to be staying there, and let me just let you guys know a little bit on the difference in the valuations from the Marriott valuation that I originally had to the new valuation for this Chicago Athletic Association Hotel. And so for my original booking, it was gonna be somewhere around $1,000 for just the two nights. And the valuation came out to about 1.5 cents per point. And I thought about it, and I just didn't feel like it was the best way to redeem those 100,000 bonus points that I got from my Marriott Bonvoy Business American Express. And so I decided to go ahead and hold off on using those points, so that way I can see what I could redeem those points for later on in the future, especially once my annual free night comes into play. Then I could, you know, try to maximize some points there, especially since I use it a lot for gas. So, you know, I'm still gonna be earning Bonvoy points. Once that free night comes into play, I'll be able to utilize that for something else, maybe if I wanna go somewhere else that's not domestic. So with the valuation that I got here with Hyatt, was the room that I got was going for $333. A night. So once I did the math and, you know, calculated what the valuation would be, it came out to be around 2.7 cents per point. And so it's a really nice hotel. I've been there before. Just know that obviously whenever you're doing your redemptions, make sure that you're getting the most out of your points. And you know, you kind of have to weigh your options on what you have if you have diversified points in different areas. So make sure that you guys consider all possibilities and make sure that you run your numbers, so that way you are getting the most value out of those points. So like I said, I'm redeeming that $333 a night hotel for 2.7 cents per point. But, you know, Hyatt was only charging 15,000 points per night, so the overall stay was gonna be only 30,000 points compared to 70,000 points. So I'm able to kind of, you know, salvage some of my points. And, you know, the good thing is that Bonvoy doesn't take your points immediately. They take it maybe about 15 days before you're set to stay. So fortunately enough for me, I was able to cancel that reservation and not worry about having to give up any of my points for a late cancellation or anything like that. So that was one of the benefits there. The only downside, I guess, was if I don't end up wanting to stay at that Hyatt Hotel, then I'm kind of SOL out of that one. So I'm for sure staying there now because I can't do anything about it. Even if I cancel, then they'll probably give me my points back, but it's gonna be in the form of Hyatt points, not in the form of Chase points. So yeah, just wanna let you guys know that. And that'll conclude today's video, guys. For more video updates, hit that subscribe button. If you found this information to be helpful, give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. Share with your friends. Drop a comment down below to let me know how would you try to use some of your points if you have any. Don't forget to hit the bell notification down the bottom left corner so that way you guys can stay up to date for whenever I drop my next video. Be a good person, be safe, be smart, and remember, credit is your life. Peace.